gives us the authorization to review the plans, enforce soldier motion matters. So on the surface, I don't know why would we want to take on that? Because it aids in helping to expedite the plan review process. We want to be able to control that part of the plan review process. Otherwise, the alternative is if you don't have that in place, it would have to go, all plans have to go to EPD, and they would be the body, that regulated body that would have to do the reviews, do the regulatory actions, enforcement, handle all the complaints. And I can tell you, just because from a manpower standpoint alone, that process takes far longer than you have to go through that agency, as opposed to us being able to have it in-house, be able to control what's being done here within our city boundaries. So that's why it's a critical step that we feel, because again, it maintains that local control for solar energy on development projects that come up. Because it's an ordinance, again, it's two reads will be required, so the goal here tonight is, yeah, this is the first read, and then to come back on August 7th with the second final reading adopted. That meets the minimum requirement for us becoming a local issue authority. And again, that keeps the control of the erosion control review in-house within the city. One thing we have talked about was, you know, starting point. EPD does provide you with a model ordinance. And it's a very minimal requirement that they want to make sure are included in the ordinance. You can amend that ordinance so long as you amend it in a manner that's more restrictive than less restrictive. So I mean, as a starting point, we're looking at utilizing DeKalb County's current model ordinance. So it's a consistency of those who are transitioning from, that's what everyone's been accustomed to. And then we can certainly go back and look at amendment over time. Typically, the amendments that take place often will fall along the lines of stream buffers, the length and the distance on stream buffers, and maybe some other ancillary items, but that's usually the crux of what we felt was in the best interest from a speedy standpoint and for a smoother and more seamless transition to start with the DeKalb County model ordinance.
Right.
Since
we're back with your tonight, a couple of comments to city manager's comments is that we're now in 2 weeks. We will have to integrate this ordinance with the zoning ordinance, because the zoning ordinance anticipates dealing with soil and erosion issues and the like. And so Emily and I talked, and she's in the process of doing that. So when you come to your meeting on August 8th, is that
7th. August 7th.
And you all speak up, please, not picking it up on
the meeting. You will be in the position at that time to not only have a second read and pass this ordinance, you will also have the same thing as far as the second read on the zoning ordinance. And at that point in time, also vote upon the ending of the moratorium. And so how this dovetails into it is what the city manager is doing, is getting all of the staff in place in order to be up and running, in order that we do the full service permits. The other part of having the ability to do the land service permits, and have the state delegate that authority to the city. It also enables you to collect nice fees, and if there are any enforcement actions, the fines are very significant. Hopefully there will be none. Some of the decisions you will have to deal with are whether or not you want to expand the buffers as far as state waters, which is everything that's got water, unless it's all encompassed by the pond in one lot. The state has its minimum buffer, which is 50 feet. In some instances, it's bigger than that, but then you have the opportunity to, in this kind of place, if you have 25-foot buffer, then you have to have the minimum buffer that you have. To make it 75 feet, you can make the buffer greater, but that's something that needs to turn with and, you know, and you can talk to all about as they have their needs concerning the zoning and those types of things. So just to let you know, after the final first meeting in August, there will not be any more one read ordinances. You get the ordinance on the following month, it's a one read. We don't have to do two reads for the first 9 days, 9 days of the year. So everything will be two reads, you know.
What you mentioned today on this city attorney, does that classify as the first read for this, or are you going to read?
No. No. We just call it first read.
We just call it first read.
First read.
We need to move for the motion forward.
Yes, it's, well, no, excuse me, no, no, it's just first read.
Very good. I'm sorry.
That's a good question. You addressed part of it, and that is, since we did not have this in here originally in the zoning, how do we anticipate, how do we deal with the lack of anticipation of staff? What is that going to lead to?
Between now and 2 weeks, we're going to have to, we'll say, Stonecrest eyes this model ordinance so that it fits and functions with the zoning ordinance.
So the zoning ordinance does make reference to soil erosion control inspections and regulations. So this will encompass how those regulations take place. As stated, right now, we'll take it from a county model ordinance, and again, we'll make it specific to Stonecrest. So the references within our zoning that make reference to soil erosion regulations will reference this ordinance.
So the person that needs to get it done already calculated in the staff that we currently bring over. I mean, in order to manage,
we anticipated that we would be handling the soil erosion components of the city.
Okay.
So on our, if you go back and pull up our org chart, you'll see a land development inspector on there. That'll be that person's duty, his or hers.
Yes.
So they actually conducted the interviews with that today to make sure we have them in place in time. That is exactly what. So the land development inspector will have the authority to serve in the manner of really exercising this particular regulation.
So there's an additional cost on that?
No, sir. This was already required.
Yes. So what does this mean for the business owner or a new developer who wants to break ground, let's say, 3 weeks? What does this mean? Is this a streamlined process? And would this be something that the business owners will be welcoming? I would think so if you're streamlining the process. I just need to hear.
I think if you were to talk to any business owner, any developer out there, they would say they'd much rather work with the local issuing authority or local municipality in regards to discussing their project, in terms of issues and concerns, being able to come in to City Hall and meet with staff, as opposed to having to deal with EPD. And again, no knock on EPD, simply because the volume that they have to deal with, it's manpower. So I certainly think, I think you get 100% consensus on the development community that your preference would be for it to be held and handled at the local level, as opposed to state level.
Mr. Mayor, thank you for giving me the opportunity to do a one-pager on really the role of the city council. I would also like to do the same thing for the executive office and yours also. Do that so that you understand what the division of the powers are as between everybody that's here. So what I have done is gone. heads up so that they're with these things and really what you're responsible to call regarding that. The first is pass laws as long as they're constitutional and as long as they're permissible by charter. Also authorize resolutions where it's not by ordinance in order to approve activities that need to be approved by ordinance by way of resolution with those. Your standard is that we will do what's necessary to peace, good order, protection of life and property, health and welfare, which I must understand, sanitation, comfort, convenience, prosperity, or well-being of the citizens. One of the things that we did pass was the responsibility for each to create their own district advisory committees. And certainly, you are having your individual sessions as far as your open houses that are there. Where I caution you with that is to be sure that if you have a forum, then there's going to need to be notice. So particularly if there are more than three of you that are going to be at any one particular meeting, then there needs to be public notice. Otherwise, there's a violation of the open meetings law associated with that. From what I hear from y'all talk about it, these are, you know, very, very, very good things to get information back to the community. And you represent your constituents, but also understand you represent the city. And you represent everybody. Even though you are from your district, you represent everybody within the city. So certainly you're gonna take the zoning decision. There will be those instances when people will want to look at whoever you are, wherever that zoning is, as to see which way you're leaning on it. That will be a consideration that you all have to do that, because only you and your particular district probably know what will be taking place in that time. The other thing is that if you're within the district and you have a process or you have people coming to you, then my advice to you is to refer whatever may be to staff to answer any questions that may be. Don't put yourself in a position where you're trying to answer the questions or trying to do whatever staff should be doing, because nothing good, the only bad can happen. You do everything right, that's fine, but if something goes wrong, you want your buffer. You've got buffers with staff to protect you, you've got me, okay, to cover your back. So be careful as you're out here, dealing with others that are out there. You have the ability to confirm appointments and nominations that the mayor has. And the mayor has the privilege of appointing the city attorney, the city manager, the city clerk, the tax collector, the city accountant, and the judges. My advice to the mayor and to council members are that where there are appointments that are coming up, is that the mayor actively communicate to you what is the point of call, and take that into consideration. It's sort of like a confirmation process if you see on TV. And there may be, for whatever reason, if there's some dirt on the person that you know about, somebody doesn't bring it up. But if the person is qualified for the position, then there's not anything to really